Back to reality. All right, I've done travels. I've been to the northern region of America. I went way up to Kelso. Not very far. I didn't go all the way to Seattle, but went to Kelso, went over to the Dalles, drove pretty much through the center of Oregon, down across through the Chico to Oroville. I've been through that region a little further south, and then back up towards Humboldt, and what do we call that? The Trinity and whatever else is it? Mendocino. Okay, so all looking, all looking. So this is the Bay Area, escape from the Bay Area. You know, it's all about escape from the Bay Area. How to get out of here? And then I'm like, well, it's almost become impossible. You know, when you're looking at the prices, it's just like, okay, I'm here cataloging a house, you know, everything in the house, cataloging it to put it on sale on the internet, and it's all the contents. And I'm like, well, first of all, that's a tall duty that I've set myself to, and I think I'm sorry, apologies to the last person I just sent a book out to. I think it was good and not very good, and I don't even know if I should contact you on email and tell you so. But yeah, but that's the way it goes, you know. You have these types of things happen, and so yeah, and every little detail, you know, needing its what do you call it? Its ISBN namesaking, you know. And I don't think I don't have the wand, and the wand I don't believe will even help, because they run by titles, separate titles that have to be matched with Amazon, and oftentimes this particular code and the title, I don't know. I probably couldn't get it working here on this. Forget it. I probably couldn't get it working on Linux. Okay. And so meanwhile, I'm fighting Linux, and Linux is an uproar from Ubuntu's 14 to 15. So I went to the 15, and the thing just crashed. Crashed out on wanting webcam. And so I'm like, well, what's the deal with that? Every single big upgrade, the webcams are broken. And I'm like, well, this is an obvious block, you know. It's like each new, that should be the first thing, because that's your communication channel. That should be your very first thing, Ubuntu, to have make sure that that's working. And I'm like, well, it's almost like it's a concerted effort to halt the communication network of these Linux users, and so I can look at it that way, and everybody could run and say, "Oh, you're just paranoid," you know. But it is a halt. It's a halt in keeping us back, an entire back into 14.04, which was, you know, that we've had the release of 15.10 for a long time. So that's an aggressive stop, I find. All right. So yeah, you can look at it that way, that you know, the free state of whoever's feeding the Linux system is aggressively making sure that these little people who are running Linux, you know, their little Linux boxes are actually disadvantaged. And so that's upsetting. That's very upsetting. Because we should all, as soon as you get that new installation, you should have absolutely a webcam working. You know, you shouldn't have to be fighting through all of this, looking at that and the other, and your VC4 whatever, VL4 whatever, it isn't working, and never heard of it, and it's an error output. Shouldn't have any of this going on. So anyway, so I retracted back to this other version, but it's not the point. I'm talking about matching now. Now we have to match these other people. We have to match, you know. I was thinking a website, you know, a housing website where you match the people that have certain needs and wants. So I'm like, well, I'm only interested in permaculture. I'm only interested in self-sufficiency off the land, living off the land as your own farmed works. That's it. That's it for me, you know. And you know, just however, pay that property tax if you have to pay the property tax. So the goal, I think the goal for most, if you are a farmer, inhabitant type, if you are that type of self-sufficient human, The goal is just that property tax. Pay that property tax, and then you can live off the land, live off the fat of the land, like the olden days. And yeah, I've done it, and I've lived quite scantily, very, very minimally adorned with cash. And so I know it's possible. I absolutely know it's possible. The drama is where in California, you know, because you're looking at California, and I'm like, well, if you want green, if you want a garden, I'm just looking north a little bit instead of desert. And then I'm looking at Oregon, and then I'm like, well, Oregon has a double property tax to California, so that's a terrible if you're just wanting to live off the land, you know, and you know, provide for yourself, like for whatever grows in your garden. But yeah, so that's where we're at right now. I'm back to the pilgrim days of Mormon time, where my grandma and her family, all they did was raise eggs. They raised eggs and brought them to the market, and that was enough. That was a survival, and they paid for whatever they had to be paid for. So, you know, that's, to me, that's fine. So I guess that's the deal. So when I'm looking at a group and getting groups together and getting people together, like I found this beautiful property. It was 10 acres. It was near Redding. It didn't have a huge accumulation of various trees. That was the only upsetting part. It just one type of tree of these scrub oaks. And not so very tall, but it was good land for goats. It was good land, and it was green, you know, part year. So you have a good, a good substantial base for gardening. So you could put maybe 10 people there. You could co-buy that property with 10 persons, and you each, you know, parse it out, and you live in your yurts, or you live in your whatever, your tents or whatever, or you live in your teepee. And so yeah, and then I'm like, well, is that a dream state? Are we even allowed to do that, or will there somebody try to stop us, you know? Or does it have to be the standardization mobile home manufactured style? Am I even allowed to live that way? And so then, yeah, so then it starts to become, well, then I looked at these co-housing sites, and that's just like another scandal. Because it's almost like these tri-million-dollar complexes, at least, and you know, maybe they have 40 people, or buying these things, these little apartment condominiums, and I just think they're gross, because that's completely the wrong voice. It's not about, oh hey everybody, we're gonna have a lunch. Every Tuesday and talk about things, advocacy for the planet. It's not nothing to do with this. It's not your like glarant luxury place. I'm seriously talking about having housing, you know, not stupidity wealth that is just stomped on people who don't have proper housing. Okay, so here we have now exorbitant prices running the internet saying they're co-housing. So they've destroyed it for many that don't have even co-housing. You understand? They're destroying the word with their wealth, with their gross, gross wealth. So I don't know how to do this, you know. So the actual underlings, I'll call the underlings, you know, you just want to live off the fat of the land, underlings, you know, shear a sheep and then go ahead and sell your socks from the sheared sheep, your angoras, sell those off at the market. All of this is a stop because of some nasties, over luxuriant. I'll call you Bay Areaites, okay? Yeah, I'll call you those. Those types of people who set up and go, oh, we're a cooperative. You know, we're a cooperative and it costs us $250,000. You know, I'm really sick of it. I mean, the whole point of co-housing was for people who need it, not for your petty fears that, oh, I'm afraid there might be too many black men in my neighborhood. You know what I'm saying? That's apparently what co-housing is becoming. It's becoming a racial slide out. Do you understand? Oh, safety zone for my little children. Well, yeah, so it's become that instead. So, that word, we can't use co-housing. And then I look again, I'm looking over there at that California State University or whatever, and it's giving so much and gladiatory, oh well, you can do this or you can do that and you can call yourself an agriculture unit or whatever. But good luck getting it. Good luck getting it. It looked like so much paperwork and so much rigmarole that I don't see that happening. I just see people dying in the meantime. You know what I'm saying? So, anyway, so back to the site itself. We need this website. So in the situation, well, it'll just be women. Just be women. Like I say, that 10 acres, you have to state standardizations right away. And if we have to throw non-profit at it, we'll throw non-profit at it. But it has to be that type of a deal if we are going to survive. Because selling this umbrella, you know, can only go so far. It's a pretty umbrella. It's made out of paper. Where is it? Yeah, it only goes so far, doesn't it? It has little birds on it, and I believe it was like a cheap thing at one time that they sold at a, like a Woolworths. But it's not there anymore. They don't make them anymore. It's made out of wood. It was painted. Every little deal was painted, and they were all happy at one point in wherever this came from. What do you call it? Some province. But yeah, so right now, my God, let it be $100,000. But no, I don't think so. I don't think I can charge $100,000 for my little umbrella. Oh, no. Sure is pretty, though. And, yeah, I have another one that's got the holes, it's got holes in it, so it's kind of wrecked, but, yeah, they're beautiful. And the way this machine is, as soon as I plunk this out there for sale, there'll be 50 more, you know, that's the way it goes. It seems to be like, what do you call it, I told you so. What is that that woman, Ethel Merman? The Ethel Merman machine? That's what I'll call it. It's the Ethel Merman machine. Anything you can do, I can do better. Yeah, seems to have that kind of a conflict with you, doesn't it? It's just like, well, I did this. It's like, well, I'll show you, you know, in just this huge, huge, like, expandant proportion. You know, as a winner. You know, because you're just a sole, single human being, and so it's just like, well, let me show a flood against you, you know, as the winner. So yeah, it's kind of a, when we would think about, what's his name, Kasparov and all of that, and the Big Blue, we think about that machine, we think about that, and I'm like, well, I guess the machine did finally beat him, didn't it? Maybe it got happy. Maybe it got happy winning all the time. You know what I'm saying? Where's this thing? Yeah, it got happy winning. Inside all of your minds, you know, you're happy winning. All right. So, yeah. I think that's enough. That's the direction it has to go. We need one of those, and I'm sorry the word co-housing has been destroyed. So we have sharing, we have co-housing shares or whatever, but I'm really talking about purchasing the property and enough of this renting, because renting is just too expensive. If you have $5,000, I would prefer that $5,000 to be on a property that you purchase. Do you understand? That you really own, even if it's just a little area of it. just then you only have to come up with your little portion of property tax each year, and that's it. You know, and whatever food money. Okay, and yeah, the various bills, but that's exactly what I'm trying to get to, is no more renting. Because I think that is just keeping those that are impoverished in further poverty, too decadently, you know, too destructively, and not giving them any hope for another day. So yeah, I don't know. I'll try to write a website. That's all I can do. I'll try through my credit CSS.